You're listening to the Spend 10K a Day podcast, brought to you by the performance marketing experts at MuteSix. This is your source for cutting-edge insight into the world of online advertising from the team with more Facebook case studies than any other agency on the planet. Here are your hosts, Steve Wise and Stuart Anderson.
Welcome back to the Spend 10K Day podcast. I'm Stuart Anderson here with Steve Wise. Today we have a very exciting topic. We are talking about how to build an effective marketing team, something we know a little bit about, right, Steve?
I think so. This is a topic that I get asked probably twice a week. What goes into building, you know, a marketing team from up top to down low, you know, from, you know, the leadership side, from the C level or the D level, all the way down to the executioners, you know, your day-to-day executioners, the person managing Facebook, the person managing Google. And also, when do you hire an agency? Like, what is the role of an agency in the grand scheme of things?
Yeah, very true. I mean, we have been fortunate to build a great team here at MuteSix. We just had a wonderful Black Friday, Cyber Monday. Lots of money being spent by our talented campaign managers.
Yeah, and I think that's something that I think is really important is, you know, you want to be able to find people that fit into the mold of a team that really get excited. The number one thing is you want to find people who really get excited by the work that they do. By, you know, managing Facebook is hard. It's really hard. And when you have success on the platform, there's a lot of excitement and a lot of camaraderie that can be bred from that success. And what I always say is that, you know, when you hire someone, there's three very important things when you build your marketing team. There's three very important elements of how to keep someone happy. In 4 years, we've only lost two employees in the whole company, which is, you know, which is one of the most, should I say on the marketing team, we've only lost two campaign people. And that's something that I'm super proud of. We also got named by Inc. Magazine as one of the best places to work. But from what I was saying, the three most important elements that I always say is the most important during the hiring process is number one, money. Number two, they have to love what they do, the work that they do. And number three, they have to love the people that they are around on a daily basis. They have to, because remember, they're spending a lot of time with these people. And I think if you can fill two of those three, either the money, the work, or the people in the work, then you're going to have a long-term team.
Yeah. So I think one of the things that I would talk about, you know, especially as somebody who's the CMO here at MuteSix, what I look for in people when I hire marketers as well is I think that marketing is just one of those jobs, and especially in our type of marketing, it has to be a person who's proactive, not reactive. They have to be somebody who's creative and thinking of ideas before they're even needed. They're not just reacting to data coming in. They're already thinking about what they're doing next. They're planning out what they want to do. Because if you have somebody who's just reacting to things, I don't think that person can be extremely effective. You want a planner. You want somebody who's thinking three steps ahead, somebody who's doing work ahead of when it's needed.
And the hardest thing, that's an amazing point. The hardest thing in finding good talent is finding someone that's both can do the execution work, can go into a Facebook campaign and really make magic, but can also think strategically about long term. Do we really want to discount right now?
Yeah.
How is this going to impact us in Q1? How do you find that one person who's both strategic as well as can execute? And I think that's very important. So on this specific podcast, I really want to have everyone to take, you know, 2 to 3 action items away from this of what they need to do to build a marketing team and how to understand when to hire an agency and when not to hire an agency.
Yeah. I mean, I think, you know, when you're building a team from basically the foundation up, a lot of what's going to depend on is, you know, obviously you're going to have the founders, you're going to have your early stage employees. If one of the founders has a marketing background, that's going to affect significantly, you know, your first marketing hire. Because if you have somebody with a marketing background, somebody who is going to be able to handle the marketing stuff in the early part, maybe that first hire is somebody more junior. It's somebody who can work with them, do, you know, it could be a social media manager, it could be a marketing analyst, it could be somebody who's going to be more on the execution side, less on the strategic side. Because the founder, the senior level person is already there. They're in the founding team. They can take on that strategic, that marketing leadership role. If you don't have a marketer among those founders, you're probably going to want a more experienced person coming in as that first marketing hire. Somebody who's going to come in to be the head of marketing and builds a team beneath them.
Yep. And the question I always get is, how could you, you know, how as a, not a marketing person, how could you really recruit a person and really understand and qualify them to fit within your team? And I always say, you know, this is where you have to get your hands dirty. If you really want to find a, you know, an A-level marketing hire, you really have to start understanding the dynamics of what it goes into running a Facebook ad, what goes into actually managing people, what goes into every single area of what the job is, what goes into KPIs, how to understand your data. You have to have the basis of level knowledge to really, and maybe you go on a Clarity.fm or you go on one of these sites and really start talking to experts. This doesn't mean you actually have to go do the work, but this is something that, this is where you really have to put the time in and really find the right hire. We've had a lot of success just, you know, hiring people in the community. Just, you know, we don't really use a ton of job boards. Most of the people that we hire at MuteSix have came recommended from other Facebook marketers. We have a very close-knit community of Facebook marketers. So where to find good marketing people? Number one, community.
Yeah.
Very important. There is a Facebook ads events. If there is a customer acquisition events, just going there and just having conversations with people. And you'd be surprised. Maybe one person you meet doesn't know an exact person for your hire for your job, but they're gonna recommend people to you. They're gonna, you know, just getting integrated into the events.
Yeah, no, I think that's a really, really good point. You know, it's such a sensitive area of business. You know, marketing, it's telling the story, it's putting up all the stuff that customers are gonna wanna see, you know, wherever it is, whether it's online, offline. You know, having somebody that you trust that can recommend somebody is huge. It's, you know, you're not always able to do that. You know, sometimes you have to kind of go outside of your own network to find somebody, and you might have to, you know, hire using a job posting, have people apply. But ideally, yeah, you always want to go through your own network. And luckily, as marketers, you know, we've been able to tap into our network of marketers. It's great because if they don't want to work for us, they have friends that want to work for us. It works out. You know, I think, you know, talking a little bit more about the kinds of people that I want, you know, to hire, especially earlier on. And I really think this goes for the life cycle of a company. You know, now with the changes that you're seeing in marketing, I think having somebody creative is great, but really you always need somebody who's very analytical and data-driven. I think the days of not being data-driven in marketing are completely over. The days of brand advertisers basically being able to say, oh, well, I think this looks good, or I think this is, you know, on brand. You have to have people who really are backing that stuff up with concrete numbers, sales, data. I mean, like, you can't have somebody who's just there to come up with, like, what you think is cool.
Totally agree. And I think this goes back to, you know, the earlier conversations of what being very, you know, finding a marketing person who's very strategic and understands what the growth of the business means. Mm-hmm. Obviously, how do you motivate someone to care about the business and not care about delivering numbers that satisfy senior management? Yeah. I think that's a huge issue in the marketing world, is how do you build a business that's not around politics? I always train our team to really work, you know, with our partners, with our clients, in that, you know, I don't care what the Facebook stats look like in a way. I want Facebook to be a growth driver of their business. I want the tall tale sign to be, what impact does this Facebook ad have on the business? How do you quantify that beyond the data that you're seeing from Facebook, going into Shopify, going into whatever e-commerce platform they have? And I think that's what I always train our team to do, is to really understand the main growth drivers of the business, because those are the variables that really affect growth.
Yeah. I mean, let's cut through and say, you know, let's say there's a marketer in the founding team. What is that first hire if you're an e-commerce company? Is it an acquisition person?
I think that if you're a brand new marketing company, I think you need to hire leadership. And the way I find leadership there, because at the end of the day, every single company we work with, there's one thing that's consistent when they have a consistent marketing team, and that's a consistent leader at the top. I look at all the successful companies we work with, and they have great marketing leadership up top.
Especially MuteSix, right?
there you go. On point today, Stu. But, you know, and I think the way you find this person is you go through other people's networks. I think you find the best marketing people in town. You go to the VCs and you say hello, you know, or if you're in a New York or San Francisco or LA, you go to the You go through some of the venture funds. Even if they haven't invested in you, say, hey, do you guys know any amazing marketing people? And then you tap their network. You try and really go through the networks to find people that are recommended. I think that a lot of people aren't qualified to go through job resumes. And you want to find people who come recommended from places of trust. And I think hunting down people who have those marketing networks is going to be the 9 tenths of the game. And you know, we're talking a lot about marketing hires. And then I feel like there's also the other side, which is when do you hire an agency?
Yeah. I think that's, you know, it's a tough question to answer. It really depends on who those early hires are. You know, if somebody's first hire is an acquisition person, if that acquisition person works out, then they might be hiring an agency later. They got to grow the business a little bit. They got to justify the cost of using an agency. They need a certain amount of scale. But if there's a company where they're hiring a marketing leader, you know, the founding team doesn't have a marketing background. They're doing what you said. They're hiring leadership and they need somebody to really do a lot of the execution. It's oftentimes more than one person can handle. And that's when you see, you know, as commonly happens with a lot of venture-backed e-commerce companies, they'll hire like a head of marketing or head of growth marketing, whatever they call it. And one of the first things that they do after that is just like, we need to find an agency who's going to be driving the ship on customer acquisition, potentially even the retention side of things. You might find agencies early on in a company's life cycle doing the Facebook ads, the AdWords, the email marketing. Those are the situations we like to find ourselves in a lot of the time. But again, it goes back to, you know, I think people underestimate just how important the background of a founding team is in an e-commerce company, because you have somebody who's, you know, got a product background. Maybe they were working at a big clothing manufacturing company, like a name brand company. Maybe they were at Nike or they were at, you know, like, you know, Levi's. Their background is product and product design. You know, that person is going to need to build a team that is going to be different than somebody whose background is on the agency side, or somebody who was the VP of marketing at a big clothing company or a big, you know, restaurant company, whatever it might be. So that founding team is really going to drive the ship for quite a while until the team is fairly large and they're just starting to fill out the team anyway.
Yeah. And I hate to keep going back of like the background of the marketing team, the background of the founding team, should I say, but I really think that there needs to be leadership on the marketing team to make decisions. Like when you find that leader, you know, they're going to be responsible for the whole marketing channel. Mm-hmm. And you know, they do require, you know, obviously to be well paid, to be well compensated, but at the same time, they're going to understand how to set KPIs for the whole marketing team, key performance indicators for you. And they're also going to understand how to manage an agency. I think that just because, you know, some of the best clients that we work with, the best partners, should I say, are people who have, you know, amazing marketing teams already set up, have great leadership, because they understand how to manage an agency and how to work, you know, within a team. Because, I mean, MuteSix is an extension of so many companies. So I'd say one of the most important things is to really figure out how do you build and structure that team? How do you build leadership? Because it's not feasible just to hire an agency and expect to magically get what you want out of that relationship. You really need to have someone who understands the marketing ecosystem to manage that relationship.
Yeah, I think the other thing, too, you know, when you hire a marketing leader, is obviously that's going to take some of the, you know, some of the pressure off of you as a founder. If you hire a marketing leader, also they're not just going to set KPIs, but they're going to set the agenda in terms of like the types of people they're going to hire. They're going to be able to attract a certain type of talent. Having dedicated marketing leadership on the team allows you to more quickly grow that team. Because if you're a founder who's doing marketing part time, because the founder's job is, you know, it's wearing many hats. If marketing is only a part of your, you know, daily job, you're going to grow that marketing team more slowly because you're not going to be able to devote as much attention to it. You know, bringing marketing leadership early on, if you can do it, potentially even if you have a marketing background, now that I think about it, it makes sense because it's such an important part of any modern company, especially an e-commerce company.
I'm going to say something rather controversial right here, but I think some of the best organizations have started off without having any marketing people on board. And I think, you know, don't be deterred if no one has marketing background or capability to run a company, to run a startup, to raise capital. And let me tell you why. I started MuteSix. I wasn't a business person. I wasn't a finance person. I wouldn't come from the restaurant industry. I came from the marketing industry. I'm a marketer first and foremost. And sometimes that desire, that love for just getting into campaigns and making changes and playing around has deterred the growth of MuteSix as a company, because I legitimately love doing this stuff, and I still am consistently curious about new features that Facebook has. And I obviously talk about it on our podcast, but getting back to the point, sometimes I think in a lot of ways that it's a great thing if the people at the top aren't marketers, because they could easily, you know, delegate that role to someone, even an advisor initially. If the advisor's interviewing, you know, specific marketing candidates, you want to build a team, and you really got to remember that besides being able to do the job, can this person fit into the framework of the organization that you're building? You're not building a marketing team. You're building an organization. It's so important for them to fit within to the framework of the organization.
Yeah. I mean, I think a good takeaway for people is, you know, again, don't be deterred if you don't have a marketing background or one of your other founders. But like if even if you do have somebody on your team, if no one can dedicate at least, I would say, 60 to 70% of their time to marketing, you need to hire a marketing person right away.
Yeah, this is one of the more difficult, I guess, podcast episodes for me, at least, because there's so many different places we can go with this discussion.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, from looking at the type of talent, the type of person, the type of skills, you know, the person, the leadership at the top, when do you hire an agency? When do you keep this in-house? How long do you keep an agency? When do you, you know, transparently speaking, you know, not from Steve who runs an agency, but from Steve who's seen so many, you know, hundreds of companies come through here over the years. Mm-hmm. You know, I definitely have a deep insight into this one specific area, both hiring, staffing, building marketing teams, and scaling. So I would say that if there's something that we haven't covered on this specific podcast episode, feel free to reach out to me directly with your questions, because I know this topic is going to open up a lot of different, you know, a lot of different rabbit holes. And if there's something that there's a specific area of this that we haven't covered, I'd love to really do another episode to really cover it, because I think we could even get other e-commerce brands we work with to talk about what went into hiring for their brand. But I think that what to really understand is that you shouldn't have the expectation that you're going to get this right the first time. There's a lot of pressure from, if you have raised capital, there's a lot of pressure from the top to grow. And whether that's just grow inefficiently, just grow. Whether it's hiring, sorry, I got to grow, I got to hire this person. I got to grow, I got to hire this agency. Really start being sensitive about, number one, your team, and number two, how you grow. Because those are the two things that are really going to dictate the long-term future of your company.
Yeah, those are really good points. I mean, I agree. It's a really tough conversation to have, because there's a lot of self analysis involved in this, because we hire, I mean, almost every single person we hire here is a marketer in one way or another. I mean, it's our entire campaign team, obviously all marketers. We have our marketing department that we've hired for, and
email marketing team, SEM team.
Yeah.
We have our affiliate team now, our influencer team, our creative team, who's also deep in the marketing. You know, we have six different marketing teams all within one organization. So definitely, you know, figuring out how to staff and how all those different teams work together has been a massive, massive learning experience for me, you know, being just a marketer and not being, you know, at the forefront of leadership. And kind of, I used to be, you know, used to being one of the smartest people in the room. And now, when I go in the room with, say, our email team, our affiliate team, our search team, I don't know half as much information about all of these individuals as they do. So I'll leave it at this. There's some really good advice that I got before I started, you know, MuteSix, and you know, I continuously believe this through and through, is that if I'm the most intelligent human being in the room on anything related to marketing, then the company and the organization will never grow. So I always focus on trying never to be the most important, and not even having the ego that I am going to be, that it's important to me to be the smartest person in the room. And I think you have to surround yourself with people that compliment you in a way that they get the best out of you and you get the best out of them. And I think that's the key to this whole world of online marketing, is figuring out, finding talented people who might not be the best right now, but under your leadership, you could help them grow and you could get them to be the best.
I completely agree. And it brings up, it really highlights, I think, actually the most important point, you know, marketers need to think about when they're hiring. And it's something that I did when I was hiring for our marketing department. One of the things that you touched on there is you never want to be the smartest person in the room with somebody. I think the way I usually phrase it is you want to hire people that are better than you at either certain things or everything, having to do with whatever your function is. So like, you know, in our marketing department here, we're doing a lot of different things. You know, I'm good at a lot of areas of marketing. There's certain areas, things like event marketing, I'm not as experienced at, that I'm not good at. When we were looking for our first marketing hire, you know, after actually, you know, having me as our CMO, I was really nervous about bringing somebody in. This is going to be a very, very important job. You're going to be touching a lot of things, the podcast, you know, our blog content, all the stuff we do with partners. It's a really, really important part of the job. So we were very, very careful to hire the right person. And luckily we hired somebody who's absolutely amazing, who's probably going to hate me after this episode goes live because this is going to probably embarrass her. But, you know, when we hired Sarah, yes, I'm going to name her the episode. Sorry, Sarah. What really attracted me to her background was how much better she was at certain things than I was. It was clear looking at her resume and talking to her references how talented she was across the board, but how in certain areas that I considered weaknesses, she was just like that much stronger. And so as a marketer, you know, you're always, it's a looking over your shoulder kind of job. You're always nervous because it's all about numbers.
For all you football fans who are listening on this beautiful night, it's the Monday morning quarterback. Every decision, you know, when you're a marketer, every decision is being questioned. Everything you do, you know, you're always being critiqued. You know, maybe you could have gotten that first down. Maybe you should have thrown on third down.
if you want to build the best marketing department, what you need to do is not be afraid to hire people that are going to be better than you at things. And I'm saying this confidently right now on the podcast. Again, Sarah, you are better than me at a lot of things in marketing, and it's made MuteSix a better organization.
Yep, and I remember this reminds me of the first time that now we're an organization, but when I first started hiring campaign managers, I was scared to death of letting people take over my Facebook ads. I couldn't sleep at night. I had panic attack, and I'll be serious because I ran all my campaign. I was so such a moron. I ran everything in a certain way, and I was organized. It was, you know, so I guess obsessive compulsive in a way that I just love being in the weeds. And it was probably one of the biggest growth areas of my business ever was just not touching the campaigns and allowing other people to really grow into this position. I think as a CEO of a company, whatever type of company you have, whether it's a B2B company and a marketing company, maybe you run another agency, you're listening to this podcast, or maybe you run an e-commerce brand and you were originally starting the Facebook ads. The business won't grow if you're CEO and you're running Facebook ads. The business won't grow if you're the CEO and you're doing email marketing and influencer marketing. You know, the only way the business grows is if you take yourself out and run the business.
That's true. Completely true. And I think we've probably given people a lot of information. Yeah, there's a lot to digest here.
There's gonna be more episodes around hiring a marketing team. This will probably be the first episode on this topic.
Yeah.
As we dig deeper into this topic and get some feedback from our listeners, we're gonna talk more about it. But we're gonna wind it down right here. Once again, I'm Steve Weiss. I'm the CEO of MuteSix. Spend 10K Day podcast. If you have specific questions for me, at least, of what it takes to grow a marketing team, please send me an email directly. That's steve@mutesix.com. If you're listening in your car, don't write that down right now. I don't want you to get into a car accident.
Yeah.
but if you're listening to it another place, feel free to email me.
Yeah, and you can email me too, stuart@mutesix.com. That's Stuart with an EW, not a U. I think this is probably been a great long episode of the Spend 10K Day podcast. So again, feel free to email us with any questions. We'd love to hear from you. Let us know concrete feedback. What do you want to hear about? We'd love to talk about the topics that you guys want to hear about. So feel free. Again, this has been another episode. We will see you again soon. Have a great week.